Today we're gonna track everything, text and objects in Final Cut Pro 10. Hey everybody, for those of you who are watching me for your first time, welcome, I'm Emilio Takas, and I post videos here on tutorials, filmmaking tips, gear reviews and much more. So if you're into this kind of stuff, consider subscribing to my channel and also ring the notification bell to receive notifications every time I post a new video. For this tutorial, we're gonna use the AutoTracker 2.0 plugin from Pixel Film Studios. I have placed a link in the description of this video for you to get it, and if you use the coupon code EMILIOPIXEL, you're gonna receive 30% off your purchase. Please keep in mind that this is valid only for the first 500 people. Let's go now in Final Cut Pro 10 and see what this plugin can create. We are in the Final Cut Pro 10 interface and we have installed the AutoTracker 2.0 from Pixel Film Studios. As soon as you install this plugin, you have two options to use it. The first option is by going into the Effects panel on the right, and you will see three options: drop zone and text, and text. The drop zone is if you wanna track a video or an image. The drop zone and text is for a combination of image and text, and the text, of course, is only for text. For now, I'm gonna use the second option, which is by adjustment layers, the titles, and it's going to be installed in your title section as well. So you go into the sidebar panel, into the titles, and let's drag the text and put it above our first clip that we will track. We have now the text layer above the video that we want to track, and on the spectre panel on the right, we have all the options that we will work on today. The first thing that we want to do is obviously track. So we're clicking in Track Editor. This window will appear. We will drag and control the track points. Let's say that we want to track our head of this woman. We can zoom in by turning this wheel here, so we can be more precise. Right now, we don't have a complicated scene and the subject is very clear, so the track quality of 50% is gonna work very good. If we have a more complicated scene, we will raise the track quality. Usually, the limit is about 85% that I use, and we will see that in the next video. I'm gonna track now only position, and we have the options to track position, scale, rotation, and the combination of all of them. Right now, position as it is, we're making sure that we are in the beginning of the clip and we're clicking in track forward. Let's go. As you can see, this plugin does a great job of tracking the objects. Here we have the keyframes. If the outcome was not the desirable one, then we can press Alt in our keyboard and the left click to delete any frames and adjust them here. And from there, we can again track forward or backward to continue tracking. Right now, we're good, so we're exporting our data, clicking on the export data. And we wait depending on the speed of our machine. Everything is complete right now. And as we said, we will work with a text right now. So we go into the tracked group controls in the inspector panel. We're making sure the text on is clicked. And we go here into the text controls. Let's say we will write tracker here. And we will click in edit text. We will click in edit text and we will click in the tracker, the word that we write, the text in our video, and we can edit now the size and the font of our text. Let's say make it here bold and place it on the left of the woman. Let's go and play. And simply as that, we have created our first tracking text. Now let's go here. Here I'm gonna make a composition of tracking the position and also the scale. So again, I'm going into the beginning. I'm dragging the text layer above the clip. I'm gonna select it. I'm pressing T here and track editor.
I'm zooming in and I'm adjusting. Let's say that I wanna track this green sign here. If we want a circle shape, but I'm gonna use a square right now. Now, it's a more complicated scene. That's why I'm gonna set the track quality to 85%, and on the tracking type, I will select position and scale. I'm making sure I'm the beginning and I'm tracking forward. I mean, the job this plugin does with tracking objects is whoa. It's done and we're clicking in export data and we go into the inspector panel. Again, the same process, we're setting the text on. We're making sure that we have the position, the scale, everything selected. The scale data, we're gonna use the X. Let's create the text that it's gonna be in the trackable path. Let's say season 1, episode 1. Clicking in edit text again. Let's change the font. And the size. All right, and we'll go again back. Now, as we can see, let's play. Now we see that as soon as we go forward, the text is getting bigger and coming toward us. But we can see that we have a weird tickering here. And this is happening because the object that I'm tracking is so small that's enlarging and shrinking based on pixel shifting. Ideally, you want a larger selection with more detail if you're going to select scale. This is not a bug of this plugin. But let's see how we're gonna fix this if we want to track a small object. I'm gonna go into the beginning of the layer and I'm gonna set a keyframe into the scale of 100%. And I'm gonna go to the end of the layer and I'm gonna set the scale to 150%. And let's see how it's gonna look. We have also the scale tracking without any jittering. Also, one more thing that we can use to enhance this text even a little bit more is by using the rotation box in the inspector panel of this plugin and the keyframes. Let's see what we're gonna do right now. I'm gonna click into the rotation box and as you can see, this rotation is gonna appear here. We can rotate the X, Y and Z axis. And let's say that we start from here. We're setting a keyframe in rotation X and at the end of the clip we will make the text come forward until here. Let's see what we have. Pretty cool, right? As you can see, you can use your imagination. Please use it free. Create whatever you want, whatever you imagine with your text and your videos, and you'll see that you have plenty of options to be as much creative as possible. I'm gonna use one more example, and let's say now that I want a drop zone. I'm gonna drag it and bring it here. And let's insert now an image into our trackable path. Again, I'm gonna select the layer of the drop zone, click in track editor. I'm gonna select the position only. Let's track the eye. Always eyes working the best with tracking objects. and track forward. We're done, we're clicking next per data, everything looks good. And we go into the right here, drop zone on. And on the drop zone source, we're clicking with the left click and we're clicking into our image and clicking in apply clip. We're setting the scale of the anchor points, let's say to 100% to make it bigger, and we will drag our layer and put it in the right. Let's make it 80%, perfect. And let's play to see now and see some combinations. As you can see right now, it's tracking the position X data and the position Y data. But also we have the option to track only the position X data. And as you can see, it's not going up and down. Or vice versa, only the Y data. And it goes up and down, up and down. As you can see, you have plenty of options to track any subject that you want into your videos.
I hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, don't forget to hit the thumbs up as it helps a lot to my channel. If you have any questions, I'm waiting for them in the comment section down below. Don't forget the coupon code EMILIOPIXEL for 30% off. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.